It never hit me till many, many, many years later. Oh, Myra, Myra, many bones in the harbor, gonna go down south and make many fresh
dollar and shake up the party. Shake up the party. In 1968, when you said to the others that you wanted to leave the band, what sort of turmoil were you in?
I'd been in that turmoil for 4 years, actually. It was a bit just the same. It was being able to express what I hadn't been able to express, I guess. I'll never, ever get to a point... I didn't then and never would be able to get to a point in my life where I was ready to stop the Seekers. I didn't really want to stop the Seekers, but I needed to do something different. I left the Seekers to find out what else life had in store, which, as it turns out, happens to be as a solo artist, as well as all the other things.
It seems like you didn't understand the level of grief that all this was...
I was totally unaware. Had I known the world was in tears, I would have been very disconcerted, I think. You know, the man I loved was in my life, and music as well, on every level. So the Seekers was part of all that. And I wasn't in touch with the Seekers fans, I wasn't in touch with the boys. It was a very, very happy experience for me, not knowing that the world was in tears.
When did marriage first become a serious proposition for you?
Oh, well, this was, that's probably your kettle of fish.
well, a serious proposition quite recently, but the idea, I think, was in both our minds some time ago.
Ron did something very beautiful. The very first thing that he said to me was, "What a dolly lady." And I had no idea anybody would look at me like that, and it changed my life. On my wedding day, it was absolutely thrilling. I'd kept him waiting half an hour, and he told me many years later he had started to wonder whether I was actually going to come. We didn't realise having a wedding at 5 o'clock in the afternoon on a Friday in Melbourne would cause a rumpus with the traffic. Silly thought, isn't it? Why didn't that occur to us? He was a very alternative thinker. He made me more of an adventurer than I had been. We went up Machu Picchu together. A gift of song. It was pretty difficult to establish myself in my own right. I didn't realise that I would have to justify my existence as much as I had to.
Do you ever feel sorry that you're singing solo instead of with a group now?
No, I don't, no. I had 5 years with a group, and in fact, I don't think I've ever had a busier or happier time than I'm having at the moment.
Ron and I were literally musical gypsies for a while. Yes, basin. We had an absolute ball singing trad jazz. What a musician, and I just can't believe how fortunate I was that he devoted himself to my career from the time we met.
Judith, you hadn't seen some of that footage before, is that right?
Oh, yes, some of it's a surprise. It's lovely to see Ron on camera. I just love it. I wish there was more footage of him. And his huge hands, I mean, he could stretch 13 notes in his left hand. Yeah, it's very, very special.
Was it his hands that made you click together?
Well, he was part of the package with Ron because he was a tremendously alternative thinker and very helpful to me philosophically, psychologically. He was very helpful, a real mentor for me, and I really needed that at the time because I was a big worrier.
You weren't certainly destined to live in one place. You lived all over the world. You lived in Europe a lot. You lived in the United States.
We did. We were very adventurous. Certainly the first 3 years were based in London when we were doing all sorts of music. But then we went over and stayed in France for a while, and then Switzerland we were based for 3 to 4 years. And it was during that time we had the transition into trad jazz again, which was such a surprise. But America, yes, once I was accepted in New York and Los Angeles a little bit, but mainly San Francisco.
Now, you and Ron actively made a decision not to have children.
We did make that decision. Yes, it came as a surprise because I thought every man would want to have children. So I thought, well, why do I think it's important to have children. It made me really question my traditional upbringing and just thinking that's the role that women and men play. But if children had come along, we always said we would have had them. You know, the time when Ron died, you would think, if anything, it might have had the opposite reaction in me, thinking, oh, if only we'd had children. But that hasn't ever been the case.
Back in 1990, I think many people would recall that you had a very serious car accident. Ron was in the car too. And one of the outcomes of that was it gave you time to think and reflect.
It was a very interesting period. It was tragic because the girl died who was driving the other car, and that was quite difficult at first to know what to do. And when I met her parents, that was a very, very helpful experience, and for them too. So initially, once that happened, then after getting that in perspective and resolving that, then I was, of course, involved with a lot of fan mail and messages from people, and that was one of the pivotal things that actually got us back together. There was a lot of pressure through the years to rejoin the Seekers.
When starlight fades, the day comes in from sorrow.
Certainly, with the 25-year mark coming up from when we'd split, that was a great idea to get together. It was quite a challenge to go back in time and become that person again. But the reward for me was to be able to appreciate everything the second time round. When the Seekers had the reunion